Welcome back to our proactive London newsroom, where I'm joined by the CEO and the CFO of Tissue Regenix. We've got Danny Lee and David Cocke on the line. Firstly, a very good morning to you both. It's great to see you again, and some interims out this morning. But before we delve into those, Danny, perhaps you can just remind us what Tissue Regenix does.
Good morning, Thomas, and good morning to your viewers. Tissue Regenix, as our name certainly indicates, is involved in the area of regenerative medicine with tissue-based scaffolds, which are sourced from human as well as animal tissue. Regenerative medicine is a branch of medicine which seeks to regrow, repair, augment tissue or organs, or utilizing the body's innate ability to heal itself. We utilize tissue scaffolds as the foundation for doing the regenerative work. Our unique platform technologies, BioRinse as well as T-cell, they gently process the tissue, so this way it's safe, but it also keeps a lot of the inherent properties of the tissue, the biologic, the biomechanical properties. And that makes it really the most ideal scaffold for regenerative medicine. Our products are used in multiple surgical specialties in spine, orthopedics, dental surgery, urogynecology, as well as others.
Fantastic. Thank you, Danny. So let's look at those interims now. Turning to you, David, tell us a bit about the first 6 months of this year.
Sure. I'd be happy to walk you through those financials, Thomas. We were pleased to report that we had 19% growth in the first half of 2023. With strong performances in both of our BioRinse and D-cell segments, growing above market rates of growth. This was the sixth straight period of growth for the group coming out of the pandemic. So very pleased to have that consistency of growth. Our BioRinse segment was up 20% in the period, with strong performances from our demineralized bone matrix, our birth tissue, as well as released donor tissue. Our D-cell segment was up 29% as we continue to see benefits from the commercial reorganization we put in place at the end of 2021, as well as sales contributions from our OrthoPure XT. On the gross margin line, we reported 49% gross profit for the period, up from 46% in the prior year. We took advantages of the efficiencies of our phase one expansion to really drive those gross margin enhancements. So the combination of those financial results, as well as, you know, our ever attention to our managing our overheads, allowed us to report an adjusted EBITDA profit of not 0.4 million, which compares to a loss in the prior year period of not 0.5 million. As a matter of fact, we've been adjusted EBITDA profitable for the trailing 12 months.
So it sounds like solid progress, David, but what is it that's actually driving the growth?
I think the foundation of our growth and our path to profitability is following our 4S strategy. The execution of that strategy across the group has been really exciting to Danny and me in terms of how our employees have embraced that strategy. A disciplined approach to supply, sales revenue, sustainability, and scale allows all of our team members to contribute to the financial results that we reported today. You know, it all starts with having an adequate supply of donor tissue, and then the capacity to process that into finished products. That allows us to drive sales revenue. And as we manage our expenses tightly, that allows us to announce the sustainability in terms of our adjusted EBITDA profitability that we reported today.
Thanks, David. So you have mentioned the performance of the BioRinse part of the business, and that is the basis for my next question for you, Danny. You've actually launched a new product in that line today. If you can just give us a quick overview of that one.
Sure. As you know, with Tissue Regenix, with the products that we offer, especially the human tissue products, this is a very unique business. It's unique because how we source the tissue and how we also have to process it in a very specialized environment. As a result, one of our missions as an organization is to maximize the gift of human tissue donation. So that also means we do whatever we can to maximize the resources that are available to us. So when we looked at our product lines and we looked at some of the product lines in which we could utilize the human tissue better, we did focus on our soft tissue product line. We worked with our customers to identify ways in which we could make it better. And we realized that it was an opportunity for us, again, to maximize this gift of human tissue donation, but also gain more market share as well as acceptance in the marketplace. So the BioRinse brand is all about producing safe, sterile tissue, which has a minimal effect. The processing has a minimal effect on the tissue. So we deployed and implemented new processing technologies as well as sterilization technologies to produce a final product that is more in line with user needs. Our market research had identified that the U.S. market for sports medicine allograft tissue is approximately $300 million. And these changes really do make it, give us the opportunity to gain more market share.
All understood. And that takes me to my final question, Danny. And that is, what do you think investors can expect from you over the next 6 months?
Well, certainly, Thomas, one of the things that our investors can expect is that we're very committed to continue to grow this business. As David's already mentioned, the four S's have provided the foundation for this growth. And our growth is going to come from a number of different areas. We're going to continue to grow our base business, as well as look at expanding into a new business within the United States. We've talked about how had the opportunity to be a global commercial organization. And as we receive additional regulatory approvals in markets outside the United States, we'll be able to achieve that. We'll be able to expand our allograft tissue business outside the United States. We also have global interest in our xenograft tissue business, specifically the OrthoPure XT. We mentioned that we've announced that in the first half of 2023, how we have expanded our distribution in the UK, announced a distribution arrangement in Australia. So that business will continue to expand. So our business will continue to evolve and grow. And we're continuing to make strides to grow this business.
Well, Danny, let me wish you the very best of luck with it. And thank you both very much indeed for your time this morning. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Thomas.
Thank you, Thomas.